Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_037_BIAB_I. Click the File tab and hover the mouse cursor to save as Project. This brings the Save Project as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_038_BIAB_I. Click the Save button. Double click the ground floor plan. In the last tutorial, we created a section view for our project. In this tutorial, we're going to place the room object into the project. Go to the Architectural tab, Room and Area panel, and select Room. Move the mouse cursor into any closed area and click. Move to the store and click. Continue to click. Moving into this area and click. Click the modify button. Now this is the living area and this is the dining area. So when you try to place a room in Revit, the room look for a room boundary. Now if I hover the mouse cursor into this room, you see that the room extends to the boundary of these walls. So to remedy this problem, use the room separator command. Select the pick line button and change the offset to 10 feet. Offset this wall to the right. Now click this node and move it to this wall. Click the line button in the draw panel, change the offset to 0, zoom in into this area, start the line from this corner and join it to this sketch, to this room separation line. Start another room separation line from this point and join it to this point. Now if I go to the Architectural tab, Room and Area panel, and select the room command, you see now the room separator can help us to divide the floor area where there is no wall. Click to place this room and click here to place this room. Now if I want to place a room where a room boundary is not found, you see the room have a limited bounded box, but if I move to enclosed area, the room extends to the extent of that area. Now click to place this. You see you get an error, but we can handle that in a minute. Place this and this one. Click the modify button. Go to the project browser and change your underlay to ground floor plan. Go to the modify tab, modify panel, and select the line command. Zoom in into this area and select the midline of the underlay wall. Select the room separator object to shift it to the right. Click the modify button. Select the room separator, click this node and move it away from this wall. Click the align command, select the grid line and select the room separator. Click the modify button, select the room separator, extend it to this wall. Use a crossing window selection to select this object. Click the filter button, check none. Select reference plane, click apply, click OK. Click the sunglasses and select hide element. Go to the Architectural tab, Room and Area panel, and select room separator. Click the pick line button, pick this line and this line and this line. Click the trim extend to corner, select this room boundary and this room boundary to trim the two extend the two objects. Select this room boundary. Click the modify button. Now the room is nicely fixed in the porch. Do the same thing at the back. Go to the Architectural tab. Select room separator. Select the pick line command. Pick this line and pick this line. Click the modify button. Select the room separator. Select the pick line command. Pick this line and pick this line. Click the modify button. Select the room separator. Click this node and move it to this point. Select the tag, right-click and select all instances in visible view. Click the down arrow and select tag with areas. Click outside. Go to the property palette and change the underlay to ground floor plan. Go to the architectural tab, room and area panel and select room separator. Zoom in into this area. Start a room boundary from the mid to the center line of this wall. Click the modify button. Now this room is bounded completely. Select the room separator command. Start the room separator from this point to the center line of this wall and to the end point of this wall. Click the modify button. To get a better view, let's change the scale to quarter inch to 1 foot. Select the room separator command. Select the pick line button in the draw panel and pick the edge of this wall, and the edge of this wall. Click the modify button. Click the room and rename this room to living. Click in an empty area. Click on this room and rename this room to dining. Click on this room and rename this room to kitchen. Rename this room to porch. Click and rename this room to store. Click and rename this room to porch. Click and rename this room to porch. Click rename this room to guest. Click and rename this room to bath. Go to the architectural tab and select the room command again. Place a room under the stairs. Click the modify button. Rename this room to toilet. Or rename this room to WC. We need to extend this room to the edge of this wall. To do that, select this wall, select the closet wall, and go to the property palette, uncheck room boundary. Now, when you select any wall and uncheck the room boundary, the room command ignore the wall. Now the room extends to the extreme of the other wall. Double click the first floor plan. Zoom in closer. Change your underlay to first floor plan. Select the reference plane. Click the sunglasses and select height category. Select this dimension and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the architectural tab, room and area panel and select the room corner. Place a room here, 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 here. This room here, here, and here. Click the modify button. Change the scale to quarter inch to 1 foot. Rename this room to master bedroom. Right click this wall and select grid similar. Draw a wall from this to this wall. Click the flip arrow. Click the modify button. Now select this door and click the pick new host, pick this wall, click the modify button, zoom in close, select this door and notch it up. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Select the edge of this wall and this wall. Click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Select the wall and change the value to 6'1". Press enter. Select this wall and change this value to 1.5 inches. Press enter. Click the flip arrow to flip the door into the other side. Go to the architectural tab, select the room command, place a room into this room. Click modify. Name this room to bedroom 3. Rename this room to bath. Rename this room to bedroom 4. Rename this room to porch. Now go to the architectural tab and select the room separator command. Select the pick line command, zoom in into this area and pick this line, and pick this line, zoom in, pick this line, this line, this line, this line. Click the modify button. If it even asks you to save the project, try it and do so. Select this wall, uncheck room boundary. Double click the S section XX. Alright, we're going to end this video here. In the next tutorial, we're going to start to dimension our project. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class.